To illustrate a point, this camera that I'm using, I have a memory cards there. I need to keep deleting the videos after I put them up on YouTube. And on one of the cards, there was this one video of a family outing. And I said, I don't want to delete that. I don't want to delete that. So then I had to individually select all the rest of the videos on there and delete them, but leave that one there. And I've been doing this for like a year or more. And it's time consuming. And finally I said, you know what? I got to download that family video to YouTube and get it off of a card. And then I can erase all the files at once. I don't have to select them. I just say all files on the card. Boom. 10 times easier, you know, so much faster and easier. So I finally downloaded it to YouTube and it said duplicate. You already had downloaded it. So I went a whole year doing this. I didn't need to. Okay. And then I just realized, hey, you know, this is kind of like the practice that we're doing now. It's like deleting all the files at once. And we think there's one file in there. We got to be careful not to delete. But, oh, we've already downloaded. It's already safe. So we can just delete everything all at once now. Much simpler, much quicker. And we are going to try to delete all our files right now by saying, I am already that. I am already that. I am already that. Now, there's a book by Maurice Freeman about Sri Nisargadatta Maharaj. I am that. I am that. I am that. And by the way, I think I might have said that Nisargadatta Maharaj was saying, I am, I am. Actually, he was silently focusing on I am, constantly focusing silently on the feeling I am. Apparently, what Maharaj said was that the title of the book, I Am That, it's referring to that which is beyond I am. I am that prior to I am. Not I am that tree, I am that. So a way of looking at this is the way I see it is that we practicing, we can say, I am already that. This brings about the most intense consternation within our psyche. This is what I feel when I do it. So it's not an easy practice for most of us, and the resistance is enormous. So I feel like, wow, this is really knocking on the door. This is very effective. I am already that tree. I am already that. So there's no space for I am because I'm already that. So it squeezes out I am is what we're doing, which is ultimately identification with time, space, process, and form. I am already that. I am already that. So we say, I am already free. I know I already successfully know that I'm already successfully, I am already that. I am already that. I am already that. Now, this type of practice is let's just delete all files at once. I am already that. And you just feel this burn because I am saying, oh, wait a minute, wait a minute, wait a minute, wait a minute, wait a minute. You say, no, I am already that. And the I am cannot process this, cannot process it. I am already that. So don't try to process, just feel this like, ah, it's like a meltdown of I am already that, I am already that pathway, I am already those stones, I am already enlightened, I am already that wall, I am already this world, I am already this cosmos, I am already all there is, I am already all there is, not I am all there is, I am already all there is. So this brings about this tremendous consternation that we can turn around as wow factor, you see. And it's like cup half empty or half full. particle or wave, when we look at it as, wow, it tips suddenly to half full, and we say, oh great, this is wonderful. Whereas if we tip it the other way, it feels, this is terrible. You know, I can't stand this, it's too much. So really, it's our choice that tips the balance in how we experience this. Now, I have a very interesting little story to tell here. In my mind, I'm always imagining this baseball game going on. The pitcher is pitching, the batter is batting. And sometimes I'm the pitcher and I'm throwing great strikes and striking out the batter. Sometimes I'm the batter and I'm hitting the ball really well, you know, hitting home runs. And I was thinking, how can I end this game? I'm tired of this game and just always trying to strike out the batter, trying to hit the pitcher. I say, which one am I? Well, this morning, something came to me. And what it was I threw the pitch. It was a great pitch. I said, this is the seventh game of the World Series. The pitcher's side is up by a run. There's two runners on base, two outs. Bottom of the ninth inning. This is the decisive batter. So two strikes on the batter. Pitcher throws the perfect pitch. I threw the perfect pitch. I said, okay, this is going to be strike three. I'm going to win the World Series. This is great. But then I said, wait a minute. Well, if I'm the batter, here comes the pitch, and the batter's thinking, hey, this is the perfect pitch to hit a home run and score three runs and win the World Series. So I'm thinking, which one would have you have done? And this has been going on my whole life. Which one? And then this is what happened. I threw the pitch, and then I was the batter. And here comes the pitch, and the batter swung at the pitch like this. And then right at that moment, there was just this timelessness. And nobody knows what happened. But from the pitcher's side, batter missed, strike three, game's over, they win the World Series. From the hitter's side, hit the ball for a home run, won the World Series. So what happened is everybody walked off the field together. Both sides won the World Series. It was both a strikeout and a home run. But it wasn't seen. It vanished. At that moment, just before the ball got to the bat, the ball completely vanished. Okay. So, what happened? Say it was both a strike and a home run. Two winners. Both sides won. The problem with this is that statistically, traditionally, what can you do with that? We can't do that. We have to have a winner. You can't say both teams won the World Series. It's impossible. The whole point is one team has to win, one team has to lose. And I said, it's already happened. It's already too late for that. Both teams actually won. And so this just basically flips the whole script of history, of tradition, of existence. Both sides won. So imagine a scenario like that where both sides can win. This is what just suddenly clicked in. And I said, yeah, I'm fine with that. I'm fine with that. Now I've been nonstop pushing affirmations since 5 a.m. It's been like 12 hours straight now, 12 hours straight. At one point, felt extremely exhausted. When some are really pushing to finish, it can affect the health of the body. This is what Maharaj, Sagarnath Maharaj said. I just read that. He said, it can happen that the body might feel somewhat ill. This is what I'm feeling now. Quite enervated, quite tired, quite ill. Since we don't know who won, it's the same as saying they both won. Why can't they both win? In their minds, they both won, you see. And so what happened was I accepted both outcomes. In other words, I didn't need a winner. So you talk to the one team, they say, yeah. Yeah, hit a home run and we won. It was fantastic. It's great. You talked to our team. Yeah, I struck them out and we won the World Series. That's fantastic. And there's no conflict between them at all. Because ultimately, I'm the one that they were playing for. So if I say, yeah, you're both won. Both won. And there's no problem with that. Because in the holy instant, both can happen. Both can happen. Because after all, it's only a choosing. And if we want both to happen, both can happen. But from an ordinary standpoint, we say, no, you can't have both happen like that. It's impossible. And what I mean is since we don't need a winner, then both can feel as though they won, although the outcome was indeterminate. We don't know what happened. It's indeterminate. Vanished forever. Traceless, vanished forever. And so I say, let everyone feel that they're a winner. Because ultimately nothing happened. And you see, in this nothing happening, if we try to get a winner in there, that's where the problem comes up. Because that can be disputed. Where everything disappears, and the outcome disappears, and we claim there's an outcome, determinate outcome, then the ego jumps up and says, wait, how come you said this happened? How can you prove that you were enlightened? Or, so you can say, well, I was both enlightened and not enlightened. But nobody knows. Since nobody knows, you can choose whichever one you want. It's just fine. So this, really squeezes the ego out. So what prevailed? Did enlightenment prevail, not enlightenment prevail? Doesn't matter. We both prevailed. Because I'm already enlightened. I'm already that. So a contest to determine to become that or not become that, it's a moot point. It becomes completely moot point. Since I already am that, the struggle between light and dark, the struggle of trying to become that and trying to prevent becoming that, which is actually one struggle. Say, hey, something's working against me becoming good. I'm already good. There's no issue of becoming that. I'm already that. So there are no outcomes in reality at all. And since you cannot have both losing, you know, I mean, how can both lose? From a determinant standpoint, you know, that doesn't make any sense. But we can say they both won. Something, if this is a strikeout, one side won. You can say, well, the other side lost. But it seems to be, and the other side could have hit the home run and won. And the other side could say they lost. But there's a winner, you know, there's a winner. And that's what we were looking for. What's the winner? So we can say they both won. And you can say they both lost too if you want. They both won and they both lost. So there was no outcome. So in all of this play of consciousness, this dream, determinism, time, space, process, form, it ends up that there is no outcome. I'm already that. So the I am trying to find an outcome. I am becoming no outcome. Both winners, both losers, you could say. No outcome. Now this fries the I am, because the I am is looking for an outcome. The I am is that which is trying to determine what is. But if everything already is, what do you need the I am for? The I am is trying to find the winning side. Okay, the winning side. And remember, in the fight of lightness and dark, so to speak, the darkness is trying to win, and it wants to win. It's the winning side. It's the I am side. I am the winner. And the other side says, no, I want to be the I am winner. But we're saying there's no outcome. If there's no outcome, what do we need the I am for? Sides of the loser. If you have both sides of the loser, how can you? It's not a loser. If both sides of the winner, it's not a winner. You can't have a winner or a loser. So what do we need the I am for? No outcome. So what we're doing is we're letting go of the notion of an outcome. I am already free. Not that, oh, I am free. So I am says, yeah, okay, I got free. There's the outcome. No, I'm already free. No outcome. This is what's... Yeah, we want to have the world as some sort of outcome to happen here. This is the trouble. The belief in an outcome is what gives us the belief in a world. Getting interference here. From the previous video, I said that the fake Jesus showed up and explained all this stuff to me. Blah, blah, blah. And I'm saying, oh, is this similar to what the fake Jesus was saying? Or was it the real Jesus or the fake Jesus? You know, it's like, huh? It's always possible to get confused with dreams. It is possible. But, so, however, it just seemed weird. It's not a question of balancing. It's not a question of balancing. I mean, this, like, it was a misinterpretation. There's no outcome. See, what we're trying here to do in this world, in the modern world, is try to get, you know, everybody a winner, everybody a winner. It seems to be going about it backwards, though. See, now I'm getting pulled away from practice. Interesting. Wow, very interesting. Which, as I says, the whole purpose of that dream was to pull me away from practice. Very interesting. Wow. And try to explain and become defensive and explain, which is a big mistake. I am already that dream. So whatever pulls us out of practice, be very suspicious of it. Very suspicious of it. In terms of getting defensive and feeling a need to defend. Oh, wait a minute. Something's not right here. I am already that dream. I am already that sky. I am already this space. I am already this place. I am already this place. This burns. I am already this place. again, use the full stop and the wow technique that puts a positive, it puts it in a positive balance there. Like, this is great. Fantastic. Wow. Really can feel the pressure here. Like squeezing out the I am. This place, I am already this space, I am already here, I am already I am. These are very advanced practices that can bring up tremendous consternation, but we're using the full stop and the wow, so wow, I am already, I am already here, I am already this place, I am already that tree. Stop in the wow. This is where this practice comes in extremely helpful. You can't get to these type of intense practices without this ability, you know, full stop in this wow. Just, oh, great. No spin, just, yeah. I am already I am. Pulled away again. Wow, interesting. Okay. So we're just trying this, we're seeing if it's possible. It certainly is possible. Certainly there's a strain, there's just a sort of an overall sense of, I am already I am. I am already this world. I am already this world. This is super potent medicine. And as we take a full stop in the wow break, just, okay, this is, yeah, it's potent medicine. I point out that we need the potent medicine now. We really need it. And there's a million reasons you can bring up for that. But anybody who's practicing this intensely knows, already knows, that this world has been incorporated, actually, from cosmic corporate culture, and it's a dualistic situation, and the sophistication of it is so much so that it's easy to get pulled into it. We're told during these tribulation times that even the elect of God, the saints of God are in danger of losing their faith, you know, being pulled down into this. So, this is why I'm trying to find, you know, the quickest way here, asking the Holy Spirit for help. And it's a strain on the body, there's no question about it. I'm feeling that. These thoughts. Obviously, this bypasses the intellect, doesn't it? It goes directly to this feeling. It's a strain, and it's a consternation. It says, I am already these thoughts. I am already this reaction. Confounding, and yet we don't get frightened because we do know from those who have realized that there is beyond the I am is the nameless, formless, absolute nirguna parabrahman. The absolute identity of, what is it? Freedom. Free. I am free. I am free. It's beyond the universe. It's beyond a world, it's beyond the universe, it's not beyond, but it does. That's not the right term. Wait a minute. That's okay. I know I already am. I am already. I am already this tree. I am already I am. This is necessary to get ahead of what's taking place with all the incorporation by the tech people of this world. It's necessary to do this. Sure, it's a strain. It's difficult. It's a workout. It's a challenge. But it's better than the alternative. I am already I am. So every minute we spend getting used to this, even though it's like, oh, wow, it's just... total consternation. Every minute we spent relaxing into this and getting used to it, it's like, oh, this is wonderful. What a great, wonderful wow here. That's saving us enormous trouble. So it's an extremely small price to pay, actually. I am already this world. I am already this world. This is basically saying there never was an I am this. I am that, I am this, I am. There never was a snake. It's always been a rope. I am already this world. I'm already the universe. I'm already I am. I am already I am. See, our defense system can't work. It's disarmed it. And this is this consternation and fear and strain we feel like. But, what do I do without my defense system here? Just sit quietly in the wow. I am already I am. I am already I am. See, getting to this is only possible by practicing. You cannot get to this by reading a book, like some spiritual book, and in the paragraphs you're reading and explaining, blah, 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 teacher says now. If you just say that I am already I am, then this helps them negate the blah, 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 blah. It can't register at that level of intellectual interest, superficial interest. It's only through practicing this full stop in the wow. This wow is a full stop in the wow, progressively bringing up the wow, getting used to doing it, and then deeper, more difficult, we get more difficult, more difficult. And now, only then do you reach this I am already I am. And then you feel the feeling of this consternation, it just, wow. Then you don't need to intellectualize it at all. Don't need to. You're right in the midst of it. You know it. Well, here in the West, we're used to getting academia and getting grades. So they tell us to read a book, and so we get the cliff notes. Okay, and then we say, okay, well, it said this and this and this and this and this. Okay. And we say, okay, I got it. You got what? The grade. But did we get what was in the book? What was in the book? It said, what's in the book is you need to practice. Actually practice. You don't get the grade until you practice. But here in the West, we get the grade by reading the book. It's basically our education system is designed in a certain way. So we don't spend time practicing, actually. So we have all our time free for what? For making stuff. For superficiality, making stuff. It's a very clever educational system we have. Which I dropped out of when I was 12, actually. Because I realized it was a trick. They want to get you through. Till your mid-20s or, 20s, mid-20s, if you go on advanced degree. They want you to get through the first quarter of your life without practicing, actually. So you've already established this in fundamental laziness. And then you're going to spend the rest of your life boosting the GNP, working on things. Very clever. So you're rewarded for how many books you can read, all this. Meanwhile, you're totally neglecting. did you do the homework? Well, I did the homework, this, and here's an essay of being on this. But the book is saying you need to actually practice. So we have a whole country in the Western civilization almost of dysfunctional people who don't know how to practice, actually, who actually think that not practicing is the way to success, because that's how they got the grades. Now, you can't go into your room and spend 8 hours every night saying, I am already I am. I am already I am. I am already this world. And just full stop in the wow. You go to school next day, did you read the book? Oh, well, the book said to practice I am, and so that's what I did. Oh, no, but I mean, did you read the whole book, all everything in the book? Well, if I did that, I wouldn't have any time for practicing. Well, I can't get an F. I told you to read the whole book. It's F. See? How can teachers give grades if you realize what you need to do is practice, and that's all you need to do? Well, what happened to all the teachers? Teachers union, and they said, no, you can't do that. We need to be teachers. We need to, Evaluate the student's ability to not practice, and reward them for not practicing, actually. Reward them for not meditating, not practicing, not affirming. Keep them busy, 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 busy. Kids today are parents are like obsessively fanatical about keeping the kids busy in superficiality. It's religion to them. This is the new world religion, actually. The new world religion is all about avoiding practice and feeling good about it and feeling successful about it. It's kind of like saying, I successfully avoided success. This is the new world religion. I successfully avoided success. Wow. Got an A. On my tombstone, there'll be a big A. A plus, here lies someone who successfully avoided success and stayed loyal to death. And because they're trying to come up with this I am, they continue to believe that this is all process, external. This is all external process that's designed to produce this I am, to become this I am. So it's like we're watching this whole thing, believing it's going to become what I am. But I'm saying, I am already I am. What does that do with your attention on all this process? I am already I am. But only if someone who's matured can handle this and feel it and accept it and say, I already succeeded. I know I already successfully know that I've succeeded in already successfully knowing that I am already I am. I am already I am, and feel the consternation, because this means that everything, all this so-called becoming, is irrelevant. And it's all like a mirage, actually. There is no outcome. So, of course, seeing it as no outcome, the educational system of this world just freaks out and says, you're just in severe need of our educational system, which is a miseducational system. And everybody's about to be monitored 24/7 to make sure that they don't practice actually. Well, what are you doing in this time frame? You know, where is the evidence of your success? Successfully avoiding success. So the best way to go about this is to practice simply, I am already, I am. I am already, I am. I am already, I am. This is like a knockout blow. There's only I am already I amness. There you go. This is a very positive way to look at it. So we're getting ourselves ready for seeing all as it is, which is what? Freedom. How could freedom not already be free? How could I am free not already be I am free? It can't be the outcome of something, right? It's no outcome. So I am already I am. So I am already the I am already I amness. I am already the I am already I amness. I am already the I am already I amness. Is the I am already I amness. All there is the I am already I amness. All there is the I am already I amness. The more we can work on this and let the consternation evaporate as it is already. Let it evaporate. Then all there is the I am already I amness. All I see is the already I am already I amness. All that I see is the, everywhere I look I see only the I am already I amness. Everywhere I look I feel the I am already I amness. This is what I'm feeling. Of course, our entire education tells us this is the very thing to avoid. Because then you're not educatable, you see. And the flip side of that is, you don't need to be educatable. Because I am already I am. See, we think education is saving us from the truth. Nothing can save us from the truth that I am already I am. I'm already enlightened. There's nothing I can do about it. Education doesn't save us from this. Well, not, but this is sort of the new religion, education, designed to save us. No one can save us. Nothing can save us. I am already enlightened. I am already I am. Nothing can save us from that. Education is the latest great hope for that. And now here comes the incorporation of the world by the cosmic corporate culture, CCC. And this is then the next great hope after that, you know, that we're going to have this like super education. We're going to have a cosmic education. And remember, and then we say, oh, well, we got hope then, right? We got hope. Well, we got hope that we can be saved from this. We don't want to be enlightened. They say, no. I don't want to, we want to be saved from that. It's too late. I am already enlightened. I am already free. Nothing can save us from I am free. I am. Is already becoming less problematical here. Again, I liken this practice to like eating a hot chili pepper. For a while, it could get very intense. Then once it starts mellowing out, you say, hey, that was pretty cool. It wasn't that bad. It was well worth it. That was great. What an experience to go through that intensity. See, everybody in this world wants to spend their time avoiding truth, thinking they can do something about it. In fact, there's nothing they need to do, and there's nothing they can do about that. We're all of us are already enlightened. But the world spends its time pretending that it's saving us from that, saving us from truth. So of course, if we don't need to be saved from truth, which we can't be saved from truth, what do we need this world for, actually? We don't. We wouldn't really choose to hang on to this world very long, actually. You don't have to let it go but right away, but there's no need for this whole type of illusion to deceive ourselves. Pure spaciousness doesn't need any particular dance to be dancing. It doesn't fear the loss of any particular dance. You can dance any dance. It doesn't affect pure spaciousness. So I am already I am. Think about practicing full stop in the wild. Don't get pulled into defensiveness and arguing and defending your position and what you're doing and all that stuff. That's when the wheels come off. So we just keep practicing. And I am already I am. We don't object to the practicing. Practicing is really our shelter. It absolutely is. When we're practicing, all this other strenuous stuff is at a distance, held at a distance. Very much a refuge. In the Eastern religions, I think in Buddhism, they say take refuge in the Dharma, which means take refuge in the practice. Take refuge in your practice, actually. save me. It's too late. I already am. Already I am. Already I am. There's nothing that can save me from that. I can't be saved. I am. Already I am. The I am can't be saved. It's already I am. Already I am. There's no saving it. It's too late. It's already gone. Without a trace. Already gone without a trace. And again, the alternative to recognizing this is to not recognize it in a very severe way. Throw yourself into a very severe delusion. So we'll put up with some discomfort here. Gladly, gladly put up with it. It's like you're in some heat, sweat lodge, or sauna, sweat lodge, and it's like super hot, and you're just pouring perspiration. Just like, wow. Now, if you realize this is helpful for you, you'll say, this is great. Look at this, I'm really succeeding. Wonderful, I'm glad I've done this. It's great, I'm just so hot in here, and just wow. But if you're thinking, no, this isn't good, I'm afraid. You say, oh my gosh, this is horrible, it's too hot, this is hideous, get me out of here, I'm suffering so terrible. And you know, put a negative spin on it like that. So, we say, great, wonderful, this bringing the heat is wonderful. Bringing the heat is what it's all about. This is like a spiritual sweat lodge. Yeah, think of this as a spiritual sweat lodge. And they're just turning up the heat, and the heat is just absolutely causing us to perspire, just... So not I am everything, I am already everything. This is the difference maker. So we can say I'm everything, we feel, oh, relief, great. Then we say I am already everything, hold that. And this is when we get so agitated. This is the strongest practice yet, even stronger than I am not trauma, I am free, I am not survival, I am free. This is I am already, I am already everything. I am already everything. I am already the universe, I am already this world. Jesus tells us every minute we spend in intense practice, it saves us 100 years of misery, something like that. Yeah, it's really, so you realize it's worth it. And it's such an incredible small price to pay. As Buddha said to that someone that came to see Buddha, who had been practicing, severely practicing, trying to learn to levitate or, you know, do some psychic power, they could walk across the river. They finally spent years concentrating. Finally, they could do it. And Buddha said, "Why don't you just give the ferryman a penny and row you across? You would have been here 3 years earlier." So, it's a small price to pay for the humility. Like, I am already I am. It's a very small price we're paying, actually. But, you know, when we get to the teacher, the guru, we're not able to say, "Hey, teacher, you know, did you know that I was able to walk across the water, the river, to get to you?"
Yeah.
We can't say that. In other words, we can't say, "I am." We say, "I am already I am." Having already paid the price, small price. Maybe it hurts our pride, you know, it's consternation. I am already I am. To help us out, we will assume the trick, the mind trick of I've already realized I am already I am. I've already successfully accepted this and incorporated this and know, and I'm comfortable with it. I'm already comfortable with this. This is something that I've already, you know, it's already smoothed out. It's already smoothed out that I am already I am. It's already smoothed out. So you take that next step, and this tends to, it's like a tranquilizer effect. It cuts down on our agitation. Saying, "Why didn't you just pay a penny and go across?" "No, I wanted to spend 3 years getting through this without tricking myself or something." No, just use this little technique, this little tranquilizer technique. Pfft, you're across just like that and you're done. You can get here way quicker. So I am, you know, no, I wanted to succeed. I want to know, I've already succeeded. I am already I am. This is something that I've already is already accomplished, already accepted, already done. I'm already free. And this is something that's already realized. You know, it's already realized. I'm already the awakened one, the teacher. I'm already that. I'm already successful at this. So from that standpoint, the suffering, the agitation, that's already finished. It's just a memory. It's like a dream that you're, you know, still fuzzily there, and suddenly you kind of remember it on and off, and then it kind of fades away altogether. You say, "I've already woken up. This is just what I'm remembering is the dream, part of the dream I was having, but I'm already more or less awake. I'm already awake. I'm already awake to this. It's no longer any trouble at all, see?" So what you do is you switch from the one who's already awake, you switch from the dream to the one who's already awake. Instead of thinking that you're the dream and you're awakening from the dream, no, you say, no, I'm the dreamer. And I realized, I already realized that was a dream. I've already realized that was a dream. Instead of trying for the dream to realize the dreamer, it's the dreamer who realizes, no, I already know that was a dream. I am already I am. Okay, again, instead of the dream, the one in the dream, the one who's being dreamed about, the dream figure, the dream, you know, in the dream, you're like us, you're aware of the dream and your stuff's happening, you're doing stuff. Instead of that one realizing who the dreamer is, it's the dreamer who realizes that they were dreaming all this. So there's no realization coming from the entities in the dream of the dreamer. There isn't any. So I know I am already I am. I don't, you see, this is the flip-flop. You have to decide one or the other. Or it gets very confusing. Who was doing the realizing? Right, who's doing the realizing? And from the dreaming standpoint, you could just say both and let it go at that. See, that just let it go, both. Doesn't matter. Because the from the standpoint of that which is being dreamed about, they think, well, they're thinking, well, who succeeded? And so you just tell that, it's both. They're both winners. Both happened, and then let it go. Because that doesn't matter, actually. It's not that the dreamed about dream figures recognize the dreamer. It's the dreamer recognizes that it was all this was just a dream. So I am already I am. I am already I am. I don't need to wait I don't need the dream figures that I've been dreaming about to recognize that I'm the dreamer. Well, what kind of meaning would that recognition have at all? Well, the dream figures would say, hey, I'm enlightened. I realize that I realize the dreamer that's dreaming me. I'm enlightened. What kind of enlightenment is that? Does the enlightenment of a dream figure really matter? It's like a symbol saying, hey, I realize I'm a symbol. I'm an enlightened symbol now. Because I realize I'm being dreamed as a symbol. So I'm an enlightened symbol. What does that have any meaning? An enlightened symbol? Does it really know? Is that knowing? No, no. That too is a symbol. The enlightened symbol is still a symbol. Still a dream, so to speak. Dream content. So we say, I know I am already I am. I am already I am. I don't become I am through a dream of realization. I don't become I am through a dream of realization. Through a dream of enlightenment. I don't become enlightened through a dream of enlightenment. I already am enlightened. I already am I am. Again, there's part of us, I feel, is distraught over this, you know, it's just this inner, like, just sobbing. sobbing and distraught, and I'm just, you know, this is so, just everything's falling apart, you know, and just, the whole dream and the dream, and the whole scheme is just crumbling, you know. Just, so, but again, the full stop, and I'm like, wow, this is good, this is great. Cup is half full. Degrees today. Bay Area. For the next 3 days, 4 days, it's just ridiculous. It's just nonstop. Mid 70s, upper 70s. Ridiculous. I am already, I am. So it's not really cold here. In the evening times, it's not cold at all. It's like, it's really like summer. Or, you know, late spring. Yeah, the people back east are saying, ah, it's terrible, we got so much snow, it's terrible. Yeah, well, guess what? This summer, you're going to have plenty of water. And out here in California, no water. So, you know, it's not so bad, right? Putting up with suffering. You're putting up with suffering now, but that's a small price to pay to have all the taps running and the showers and the pools and water everywhere. There's nothing better than the water everywhere. Just feel like, wow, we're not going to run out of water. We got plenty of sunshine here, but no water. That doesn't work very well. Got a little bit of water here. If the rest of the country doesn't like all this water, snow, whatever, send some our way. You know, start saying, hey, California, here's some water for you. And that can work. That can work. Collective will like that can send some water to California. So you don't have so much snow there. But I should say the West Coast. Send some water to the West Coast. So they don't need to practice. That's what liberalism is. They're convinced they don't need to practice. Practice what? We're already very smart. Practicing would be humiliating. It'd be to say, why do we need to practice? We are already smart. We already got our education. What do we need to practice? It's like saying happiness is knowing you're already smart in terms of not practicing I am already. They say, no, we're smart enough to know that's what we don't do. You know, that's the smartness of the world. We're smart enough to know what we don't do in order to believe that we're smart. Keep believing we're smart. Instead of saying, I am already smart. In the form of I am already, I am. So no matter how smart anyone is to say, but I'm already that smart, I'm already smart. You think that's smart? I'm already smart. I know I'm already smart. I know I am already smart prior to the smartness. always prior to the smartness. And then this is practice, actually. So the idea is, hey, I became smart. I say, no, I'm already smart. I was already smart. I am already smart. Prior to becoming smart, I am already smart. Just before I went to sleep, I think it was like 2 nights ago, I lay down and I was in this mood of, okay, let's just relax, release my thoughts, and let them go. Somehow, I was willing to experience the creativity of the mind just as it is, without me being involved in it in any way, And what I experienced was this seamless tapestry. It was literally a seamless tapestry, as if it was flowing past me, like this endless tapestry. And upon this tapestry were just endless decorations and creative expressions. And it just went on and on and on in the most incredible rich variety that is. And I just sat there just watching it. That's it. So I just put on this display. And I could see the creativity of the mind. It's just fathomless. It's not even understandable. It's just. See, the I we're trying to build up as an image. We're trying to turn the mind into an image. So I is just like a way of referring to collecting images. See, I am the image collector, as if there's some collector there. But actually what we're doing is we're just taking images and trying to collect so many images that it turns into an I, that our self becomes an image. But instead of taking images of this seamless tapestry, I just let it flow past me. I just let it flow. I didn't take any images at all. And it just kept flowing and flowing and flowing. I just sat there like watching a movie. I wasn't doing anything. I wasn't making any effort at all. I was just watching it. Eidetic imagery, so just flowing past me. It wasn't static. It was flowing past me, as it were. Ever new creativity appearing on this tapestry, seamless tapestry. The tapestry is like a river of creativity flowing past me and just watching it. Didn't take any images of it. Didn't take any mental snapshots. Did not. I am free. I am still spirit, exactly as God created me. I am not an image. I am free. I am still spirit exactly as God created me. I am not an image. I am free. I am still spirit exactly as God created me. So we think that compiling all these images, it's some magically getting close to being transforming ourselves into an image. And so we don't want to let that go. We think it's almost happened. Nothing has happened. They're just images. There's no question that once I became deluded and the education took root that you need this is what you need to do, I became voracious in looking at images, reading and looking at images. I must have looked at almost uncountable images. It's just incredible. We always had all these magazines and books, subscriptions and library, and constantly I would spend just all my time, you know, going through, look at this image, and taking pictures. I grew up taking pictures, working with graphics. I just had a massive amount of image, thinking that, oh, what happened to myself? It's gone. Oh, the way to get it is a new self. What out of images? Okay, we need to build a new self to take the place of the one that's gone, so to speak. So it's very helpful to practice the seamless, like, flowing past you. You're just sitting there letting this all just flow past you. Don't try to take notes. Don't try to name. I didn't try to name anything. I didn't say, oh, look at that, you know. No, I just said, whatever arises, let it arise. I'm just going to see how creative is our mind. I'm not trying to take an image, make any images out of it. I found our mind as this inexhaustible source of just sublime creativity beyond, you know, just there's no limit. So having this imagery just go past. Just let it go. Just let it keep going. It goes off screen. New stuff's coming on constantly. This is going off screen. Practice. Don't try to identify. Don't try to name. Don't try to image it. Don't try to remember it. See, the creativity of the mind is so great, you don't need to remember anything. There's no lack at any point. There's no point that I ever see a gap or a lack. And it was all just wonderful. And I didn't feel any need to remember it, any of it. Because I felt like the mind could present it again. The mind could present it again. And even put the great variation on it and everything without any effort at all, instantly. There's no sense of time, like it's going to take it some time. No, whatever. It can present anything at any moment. Just experiencing that. Somehow I kept my brain out of it. Maybe that's what Jesus says, relax your mind, release your thoughts, and let them go. Get out of your brain. You don't need your brain. Brain is a body, brain is an image maker. We don't need to bring any of this to earth. We don't need to bring heaven to earth. Bringing heaven to earth means making images out of heaven, making images out of reality, and building a world out of images. We don't need to do that. I make some videos of this seamless tapestry going by. And that in itself is a meditation. Getting used to that. That's a very pale echo of what's available always within, but it might help. I don't know. I hesitate to do that, but it's because it. I don't know. I just sort of like I'm not sure, but it's possible. Develop this technique of having a seamless, almost seamless, seemingly seamless, if you just overlook the flaws, of course. If you're looking at it as a technical achievement, you'll miss it. That's not the point. It's as if it were just the mind was presenting this seamless tapestry, a river flowing past you. There's just this river. You're just sitting there. You're static. The river is flowing past you. And as along the river are all these boats or flotations, some stuff floating along the river, and you're just watching this endless parade float past you. This beautiful, creative parade. And you're not doing anything, you're just sitting on the bank, not doing anything at all. You're not taking pictures of it, you're not taking movies of it, you're not making notes, you're not naming, you're not judging. And I say, well, I think this is the best, and I like this one better, and you're not sorting anything out. You're just letting the river flow. We'll see if this is a helpful practice or not. I don't know. Or maybe it slows things down too much. I'm not sure. Have to be careful with graphics, really. I could make the videos private and then and invite people and give them, you know, the link to it. For those who feel that they're, you know, that would be helpful. Putting them out in the general public, since it's Creative Commons, people can copy it and then use it to try and, you know, advertise nature. We just certainly don't want that. That's not the purpose of it, actually. It's not to try and say, hey, this world is so beautiful. That's not the point of it. Point of it is get used to this seamless flowing past you. Of different forms of creativity and beauty, and just let it keep on flowing. You're just there experiencing what's going past. Not grabbing hold of anything. Say, wait a minute. Reverse the tape, you know. Stop. Go back. No, just let it flow. Just let it keep going. Find out how creative it is. You don't know what's next. Just let what's next come. Just let it flow through. So this is a meditation. It's a different type of meditation that may not bring up the same sort of, you know, intensity of I know I already, I am already, I am. I am already, I am. Yeah. But keep practicing. So if you're burned out on this, then switch over to something else. switch over to reading some holy book, or switch, you know. Keep what's really effective is to go from one slight variation to another, and keep your day going that way instead of saying, "Nah, I'm gonna quit," and just watch some, you know, murder mystery or, you know, something on the news. I want to watch something traumatic, you know. And that's caused the problem. Not good. So I've tried to have enough variety on this channel that, you know, you can have something to go to at any time. Say, hey, I can go to this. This is how I feel. I mean, I feel this little bit, you know, I'm going to smooth out with watching this. I have those Ramana Maharshi videos of just sitting there. And he's just sitting there, okay? Just let this all flow. It's just all flowing. Because I am. I know I am already I am. There's nothing I need to do. And there's nothing I can do about it. I'm already enlightened. So let all this stuff flow. Doesn't matter, you see. I don't need to make images of it, any of it. So there's those practices, a variety of practices. So, you know, you can watch this video and then say, maybe go to another one. Say, oh, let me watch if I want to spend some time on the internet. Let me watch this one instead of going to the television set. Television set is ruinous. Try to stay away from it as much as possible. I'm trying to stay away from it more and more. I'm trying not to watch basketball anymore. That's what's going on now, basketball. The Golden State Warriors are having a historically great year, and it's like, wow, after like just an incredibly long time of just hideous, hideous basketball, suddenly they're fantastic. But I'm saying, you know, there's something better to do. Let's tape. Let's look. Watch these videos. Look, we're in a time crunch here. We got to get this. We got to squeeze time out before time, you know, envelops us, incorporates us. We don't want to be incorporated by time. That's what the CCC is doing. And let us incorporate you in time. We'll be merciful and quick. Don't worry about it. And we're saying, no. Let's squeeze time out. Let's squeeze time out. I know I am already. I know I already. Man, I know I. I am already I am. I am already I am. I am already this tree. I am already this day. I am already this day. I am already this hour. I am already this minute. I am already this second. I am already this instant. I am already this instant. I am already this instant. I am already this year. I am already this millennium. I am already this million years. I am already this billion years. I am already this time. I am already eternity. I am already eternity. Now, if you just relax your mind, release your thoughts, and let them go, and just let the mind's creativity just watch it. It is better than anything you'll see in this world. It is way better. And you say, why in the heck do we need this world then? That's ridiculous. I turn all this stuff into images. Why would I want that? That's ridiculous. Well, there's a mandate. This is what you're supposed to do. No, it isn't what I'm supposed to do. It's me trying to be stupid. God didn't say I had to be stupid. I chose to try to be stupid just for a whim. I don't have to do it. I don't need to do it. I am not entangled. I am free. I am not needy. I am free. I am not I am not design. I am free. I am not purpose. I am free. I am not set design. I am free. I am not a body. I am free. I am not an image. I am free. I am not a cure. I am free. I am not a remedy. I am free. I am not an answer. I am free. I am not a question. I am free. I am not a remedy. I am free. I am not any remedy. I am free. The mind is already free. This produced another wow. I was gonna say, maybe I'm ending the video. That was another wow. Wind sprints. Do your wind sprints. Feel the burn, feel the wow. Cool out for a little bit, and then you know, you do another. So that's how you get in shape. You want to get in shape, that's how you do it. So, I would say, you know, it's kind of like you have these bursts within a longer block of time. So it's kind of both. So some people say, I like doing this really intense, you know, for a little while, and that's it. And some, I like to go slower, I like to go slower. It's both, actually. Both. So incorporate in your practice the intense burst of, you know, really where I am. Already, I am. I am already. I am really intense. Go for it until you just feel wow, and then full stop in the wow. And go through that for a while, and you finally, your spiritual heartbeat calms down, and then another burst, and then let it calm down, then another burst. And we can do this all during the day, actually. So don't think you have to stop after 2 hours or whatever. Stop now. We can keep doing bursts. We can keep having these bursts. But don't go into a coma by watching television, which most people do, right? It's very convenient. Eating dinner, sit there, turn television's on. Yeah, I just watched the sports wrap. What happened today in the Bay Area day of sports? You know, what's going on? It's just easy to tune it out. Pretty, very superficial. You know it's superficial. Very so, it's great. Something. Ants invaded today. The ants invaded again today. I don't know why. What's going on in their mind? They usually come when it's cold and wet. Now it's really hot and dry. It came in. See what we can do. Very great. That's it for this one.